Hey everyone, Micah here with Electrek, and today we're reviewing the Cyrusher XF900, a full suspension, fat tire electric bike. Let's check it out.
The Cyrusher XF900 is one of those e-bikes that takes a more is more attitude. It doesn't cut corners when it comes to the drive system. In the back, we've got a 750 watt nominal hub motor in the rear wheel that puts out a peak 1500 watts of power. That's a whole 2 horsepower powering a glorified bicycle here. Supplying that power is a high capacity 48 volt and 17 amp hour battery with 816 watt hours of capacity. Cyrusher claims a max range of 100 kilometers or 62 miles, but that's on pedal assist under ideal conditions. Everyday range is likely a third to a half of that if you're doing a mix of on and off-road riding with a lot of throttle thrown in there. In addition to a hand throttle, you've got a pedal assist system combined with a 21-speed Shimano transmission. That's a lot of gears down by your feet, perhaps more than you even need in my opinion. The extra gears are great for hill climbing or fine-tuning your pedal cadence, but high-power e-bikes make both of those situations much less critical, so I'm not sure I get the need for so many gears here. But again, the Cyrusher XF900 is one of those more is more e-bikes, so that's just one additional example of the bike's excess. When it comes to riding, you can tackle both the concrete jungle or a real jungle thanks to the combination of those massive 4-inch fat tires and the dual suspension. Up front, we have a dual crown air fork that works decently well. It's not the fanciest, but it definitely absorbs those bumps. For the rear, we've got a spring shock, which is similarly good, not great. This isn't pro-level stuff, but it's much better than your typical box store full suspension bike. I found that between the suspension and the big tires, I could hit everything from grass, dirt, sand, and gravel. I didn't even have to stick to the trails. I could basically ride anywhere, and the tires just sort of figured it out, conquering any terrain I could throw at them. This bike isn't necessarily the most nimble, few fat tire e-bikes are, but it doesn't handle like a boat either. It's fast and powerful, but I rarely got it up to the top speed in the dirt. Instead, road riding was where I could really push the speed. The bike hits 28 miles per hour or 45 kilometers per hour at the top end, and it can do it on either pedal assist or throttle. One cool feature is that the pedal assist level actually affects the throttle power too. So if you reduce the pedal assist level, the throttle also gives less power. That's great for low speed maneuvering, or if you want to let someone try your bike without giving them a full throttle experience right off the bat. Now, the bike isn't perfect, and I do have a few complaints. First of all, the fenders are cheap and floppy. Fortunately, the rear fender is trapped by the rack so it can't flop around too much, but these are not high quality fenders here. Next, I don't like how the taillight is built into the saddle. It means you'll have to keep replacing the batteries for the taillight whenever they wear out, and it's gonna get blocked if you put things on the rear rack. And lastly, the price is a tall order at $2,799. Now you do get a lot for that. This is a powerful and fast fat tire e-bike with full suspension, hydraulic disc brakes, included rack and fenders, 21 speeds, built-in lights, etc. But it's still a significant chunk of change. That being said, that price actually stacks up pretty decently against other full suspension fat tire e-bikes. This is an expensive category of electric bikes. So all told, it really comes down to how important it is to you to have a massive, excessive e-bike like this. The power, speed, and ride comfort are all great, but you have to pay to play at this level. If you do pull the trigger though, I can tell you for sure that you'll be grinning from ear to ear until you start picking the dirt out of your teeth.
Thanks for watching everyone. I hope you enjoyed that review of the Cyrusher XF900. If you did, why don't you give this video a thumbs up? And don't forget to subscribe so you won't miss any of our future electric vehicle videos. We'll see you here next time.